one last opportunity for Colorado to try to get bowl eligibility. They go out to Cal, a team that struggled quite a bit early in the season, but the last few weeks, this has been one of the better teams in the conference.
Especially defensively. I mean, they've played really good defense the last several weeks. I mean, we've seen Washington State here a couple weeks ago, and then anybody that watched that game, 55 points in the first half against Arizona. Well, this Cal team held them to, what, 19 points? Mm-hmm. And, Washington State needed a last-minute touchdown to win that game. So Cal's playing great defense, and that's not a good recipe for this Colorado team right now because the Cal's one of the four best defenses in the conference, right? And the other three they've played, Washington State, and Utah, have all really kind of hammered this team. So that's not a good recipe right now. It doesn't seem to be the right team for them to play under all these circumstances, but certainly it's going to be a tough one.
Justin Wilcox, Tim DeRuiter, two really good defensive minds. So it's not surprising that they've gotten really good on that side of the ball with those two guys on staff there. Kurt Roper said this is a defense where it's like 11 guys playing in harmony together, and there's not a lot of breakdowns. And again, to your point, Colorado's offense has not been able to get going here in a while. What do you think could give them that jolt in this game, if anything?
Well, I think a lot of it is going to be their attitude and really their confidence. I think it sounds easy to say, but if they've got that, I think they can go out there and get some things done. I think part of it is they've got to kind of figure out what it was that worked early in the season. Nebraska's got some good players on defense too, and they went out and did some good things there. Arizona State has some good players on defense, and they did things there. So they've got to kind of get back to that. Trayvon McMillan has mentioned in a couple of weeks that, hey, I think the run game can work if we stay committed to it. And I don't think he's saying that as a criticism to coaching. It's just more of, if we can get into a position in the game where we can run the ball consistently, we can have success. So if they got to keep the score to that point where they can run the ball.
Cal's defense has four more interceptions than touchdowns allowed this season. You don't see that too often. They've got two of the top three tacklers in the entire conference, so some studs there. Steven Montez was knocked out of the Utah game, but from everything we're seeing and hearing, it sounds like he's going to play in this football game, which obviously if he's not out there, they don't really have any chance in this game.
Yeah, and I hate to say that about the backup quarterbacks, but from what we've seen out of them right now, it shouldn't give you a whole lot of confidence in them. And maybe those kids could rise up if they need to, but it does look like Steven will play. We saw him walking around today. He was certainly giddy about the Sweet Cow ice cream they got today, but he looks fine walking around. He said he feels good, so I think that's good news for Colorado fans.
They had all of their top receivers back in the Utah game, so it was a little bit surprising they couldn't get more going offensively. Speaking of that group, Katie Nixon called this the new wave. He expressed a lot of enthusiasm for where they're at, despite losing their head coach. It seems like on some level, when Rick George says he wanted to provide some kind of spark for this program, it sounds like maybe that's happened.
Yeah, I think it has, and I think you and I were talking about it before. You get 110 guys on a team, and I think there's a lot of guys on this team that are genuinely sad to see Coach McIntyre go, and will miss him and are grateful for everything he did. But 110 guys, not all of them are going to like a head coach, and I think there's probably a certain number of them that are glad to see a change, and that it probably has energized them. But I think for those that even did like McIntyre, that this is probably some sort of a jolt, and because it is a reflection on them, and maybe it's a wake-up call for them. And by all accounts, from the guys we've talked to, it sounds like there is some sort of new energy there. Yeah. That a lot of times that's what it can be, is just a wake-up call and say, okay, wow, we really got to get our act together because this university is serious.
Yeah, I know we as media members, fans cringe when you hear the coach say, it's been our best Tuesday practice ever, or our best week of practice ever. And a lot of times it doesn't translate to game day. But I've had a lot of people unsolicited tell me that this group has a different edge about them this week than they have in recent weeks. So I'm going to have that play into my prediction, honestly, because I do feel like this has galvanized the group somewhat.
Yeah, I do too. And I think that it's positive signs. It sounds like, everybody's curious about J-Mac and, what's his mood like this week? And obviously it's very tough on him. And it sounds like today he was out there having a great time. A lot of his teammates have said he came out just kind of a new energy where they were just like, whoa, where'd this come from? Because obviously he's been down for a couple of days. And J-Mac could really be a key to this team this week, because if that's how he's feeling and he can get past it and show that throughout this week, I think that can be huge for this team. And I hate to go back to 2010, but we saw that a little bit with Cody Hawkins. He was under the same situation when his father gets fired with three games left, and Cody really handled it really well and came out and helped them win the next two games. And, you know, could Jay really be a key to this team this week if that's how he's handling it? I think if that's how he's handling it and that's how he is all week, that could be huge for this team, and they can feed off of that.
We talked a lot about Colorado's offense going against that really good Cal defense. Cal's offense doesn't really have any spectacular players on it. They've struggled to get yards and score points this year. Evan Worthington, if he could come back, we don't know what his status is going to be. That would be huge. We heard Darian Rakestraw made a lot of mistakes when he was in for him.
Yeah, and boy, Evan Worthington, you can't substitute that experience, right? I think Darian Rakestraw has – you know, I've liked some things he's done back there, but clearly the things we've heard, you know, there were some assignment errors and things like that really come with experience, and you miss that with Evan Worthington. I think if he can come back, that's going to be huge for this team. Cal's offense, they've run a couple different quarterbacks at times, so that'll switch things up a little bit. But if they're healthy, I like Colorado's chances on defense.
And we've heard Kurt Roper say multiple times one of his keys this week is to get this team feeling fresher, that they've been kind of a beat-up group. And if Worthington's out there, this is the healthiest the football team's really been since very early in the season, maybe week two.
Yeah, and that's one of the big things that, you know, I know we criticized and fans hated hearing it from McIntyre throughout the losing streak, but he kept bringing up the injuries, which nobody likes to hear the excuses, but they were true. You know, they were banged up, and, you know, if they're healthy – I mean, you think about it, when this team was healthy, they were 5-0. And if they're pretty healthy this week, Chenault's back, Nixon's back, Jay's back, Evan's back. If those guys are all back, then I think this is a different football team.
Not surprisingly, Cal's a pretty heavy favorite in this game. It opened at 11 points. It's about 12.5. We're recording this on Tuesday. That seems like a lot of points, especially for a Cal team that really doesn't score a lot themselves.
Right.
I think Colorado covers. What do you think, and what's your score prediction?
Yeah, I think Colorado covers. And, you know, I've been Mr. Optimism throughout this whole this whole losing streak. I just keep thinking they're going to get that sixth win. I was pretty sure for a while they were going to get to seven. That can't happen right now. But I keep thinking they're going to get to six, and I've got to stick with that, right? You know, I've been saying all this all along, they're going to get to six. And so I'm going to say that all this, the new wave, crashes into Cal and creates a win. I think Colorado not only covers, I think they go out there and get a win.
All right, I can't join you on this wave that you're
riding. But I have to stay with my optimism, right?
All right, fair enough. Yeah, I mean, from everything I've seen and heard with this program since Mike McIntyre was let go, makes me think this team is going to come out and fight and fight and fight. Mm-hmm. But Cal's defense is just too good for what this Colorado offense has been putting out on the field in recent weeks. And we'll see. Maybe Darren Cheverini, not that he was handcuffed, but maybe he's freer as a play caller. So yeah. I'm really curious to see that. I just can't predict a win here. I'll say Cal wins this game 23-21. I almost said 30. There's no way Cal is scoring that many points.
Well, as you were doing that, I realized I didn't give a score, and I was about to go 23-21 as well. So I got to go. So you're going 23-21 Cal.
Yeah.
I'm going to go 23-21 Colorado because I agree that Cal's defense is pretty good. I'm not sure they get in the end zone a lot, but three James Stefano field goals, including one towards the end.
All right. Well, this is the last chance, like we said at the top, this group of seniors, if they don't win this football game, it's it for them. And another year where we wouldn't get to cover a bowl game.
Well, and the thing is, you know, I would feel bad for you because I know that you're tired of being around your family in the holidays. You mentioned that a couple weeks ago. I'm kidding. Obviously, you know, neither of us wants to be away from our families on Christmas, but I know that we both want to cover a bowl game. So maybe that's part of the prediction there. But, you know, I really think that this team's got it in them, and I like the energy I've seen this week. And I hope they get to a bowl game because it'd be nice to cover it. Exactly. And I'm tired of not covering bowl games.
Yep. All right, we'll be out in Berkeley. We'll see you after the game.